1984 to 1997 have brought good friends, great times, and endless memories, both good and bad, to 75 young adults which will never be forgotten. This very special evening has brought together the 1997 graduating senior class, along with teachers, administrators, parents, grandparents, brothers and sisters, family and friends. We have all gathered here to share this special time as we take the first step in the rest of our lives. It is now time to enter the real world, as they call it. Many of us will be following pathways which we have never traveled or experienced. As each day goes by, the future grows ever closer, and it is these times that need to be cherished. Now is when new goals will be set, greater challenges created, as we reach higher and higher to climb our ladder in life. Let's begin our remembrance with Nathan Hart. He will take us back to the very beginning in 1984 and through our elementary years when we started out at just 3.5 feet high and a new box of crayons was a really big deal.
It was 1984, the first day of kindergarten, and we were going to school on our own. Mothers, including mine, took pictures. Someone packed for lunch, and Will, well, he was just confused about everything. We got to do those really neat school programs just so our parents could go ooh and ah, while Justin and Devin became stars. Halloween was the best part of the year, with costumes, candy, parading around the hallways, and even more pictures for our parents. Kindergarten graduation put the year to a close, and Mrs. Warrington, Mrs. Beisler, and Mr. Bushido said they would never forget our class. First grade came next. Class parties became popular, which Kathy took to heart, and field trips were a new experience, especially when Mrs. Gamble, Mrs. McCormick, and Mrs. Porter took us to the Bellevue Train Museum. And don't forget the trips to the park, followed by a stop at Krieger's for 1,000 pictures. And the Challenger explosion. We can all remember that tragedy of that event and recall being packed in Mrs. Gamble's classroom. In second grade, with Mrs. Klaus and Mrs. Stevenson, all sorts of things happened. And just for Jessica's benefit, I did pee my pants that year. Halloween was the same old thing. Potato skins tasted great, and Jasmine attempted to be a princess. Yeah, right. The year was complete with the alphabet program, which some of us did better than others. The highlight of the third grade was the school program where we played the roles of students trying to decide where they were going to take their trip. As kids, we began to show a little talent in and out of Mrs. Alt's and Mrs. Franker's classroom, even the softball field. Pool parties were a new experience, while Heidi shows her form as Peter Pan, Jeremy began his pattern of breaking the tradition, and we'll never know what Adam was doing. Fourth grade found some of us learning a few things with Mrs. Reinhardt and Mrs. Curley, but for Matt, things will never change. Kathy seemed to have a birthday party every month, and softball was our big sport. The Bascom Parade was always a big hit. Music programs involved everyone, and during choir, the audience had fun playing Where's Waldo, right, Ben? We did lots of things with our friends, including our annual trip to Cedar Point, but there was still always time for dear old Dad. Fifth grade was the year of the film shortage. So where was Linda Krieger when you needed her? Mrs. Elkert gave Chris a wake-up call he never will forget. And Mrs. King taught some of us our first lessons in advanced math. Lindsay experienced a bad hair day and money withdrawal because her mom didn't buy her anything. While all Michelle wanted was a Garfield coffee cup. Finally, the senior year of elementary, the sixth grade. Soon we'll be ready for the big time. We didn't build a castle, but Megan built a house. Matt was king for a day, and likely remembers being blessed by Mr. Seamer. Benji learned pencils, and Mandy had a scruffy over time. Mrs. Jordan took us around the world, and at least two of us were all smiles as we headed for junior high, knowing that whatever we do or wherever we go, we'll always remember the good times and realize we'll always be friends. Heidi Smith will now share with us the impossible mission of junior high.
Junior high, your mission, if you choose to accept it, is to revive the next 2 years of change. Watch out for upperclassmen who dump your books and constantly pick on you. Unless you remember your locker combination, this message will self-destruct in 5 seconds. Tips and memories for survival from an outstanding graduating class are as follows. The hallways can be a bear, so watch out. Put your best foot forward, as Jamie's illustrating so well. Most agents find it tough to travel light to class. Speaking of which, where are your books, Mr. Oddie? Any class may seem unbearably long. Wake up, Scott. But teachers, such as Miss Kramer, always made it interesting. Science seems to be the class that sticks out in everyone's mind. Boy, those science projects were dirty. The odds were 8 to 10 that Andy was the first to go. And so, Mr. Spacewood, have you discovered if we sink or float yet? Many agents found it helpful to fulfill their mission by getting involved. Look at these little guys. It's hard to believe that they are the future Hopewell State qualifiers. Did the meningitis hurt your playing ability? Two of our agents, Erica and Monica, used their smiles and school spirit to complete their mission to cheer. Don't forget to stand up, sit down, fight, fight, fight. During summer practices, the junior high volleyball team learned the basic skills that would take them to state. Other agents were involved in various organizations, such as 4-H. Good work, Ben. Thank you, anyone? At this time, agents were also completing missions in other areas of life, such as church confirmation. Now, all this training and change can be tiring. Sweet dreams, Mark. But there is a fun side to being a junior high agent. Your first teenage party. Something this class has learned quite well. Care to demonstrate, Jamie? Your first boy-girl parties were in full swing. Don't you guys look amazed? While some, like Michelle, like to party and relieve the stress of the junior high, others were more quiet and shy, like these two angels. Some parties had various themes, such as football, nice cake set, while others were just get-togethers to have fun. Junior high can be a very stressful and trying time. Take these tips for survival from the class of 97, and your mission will be complete with activities and parties. Good luck with your high school mission fulfilled with challenges and fun. Your leader for the high school mission will be Jasmine Snyder.
Our freshman year, the beginning of the Final Four, suddenly we were the youngest yet again. We went to our first homecoming week. Summer class and German gates were elected to the court. Everyone got all dressed up for the big night. Adam and Mark are found bonding at the gate. Another big project our freshman year was a school musical, The Wizard of Oz, with many of us participating in the production. One thing that we all enjoyed was hanging out with our friends. Michelle seems to be the happy one this evening. Our freshman year was the first time that we were in activities with the older students. Community Shine shows through in the band, and as our freshman year closed, Monica and Misty were happy to have survived. Our sophomore year was not too different from our freshman year, except we were no longer the youngest. Erica Decker was homecoming attendant, and Brian Coppice was her escort. Many of us were active in extracurricular activities. The volleyball team made its first appearance at the state tournament. Kathy and Erica were dedicated to cheerleading. Jamie stayed in shape by riding her bike, and Jeremy's pattern seems to be continuing, while other classmates took up modeling. A few of us went to the prom, many of us stuck like the driver's ed, but some are still stuck on the bus preparing for a track meet. The end of another school year again approaches, and everyone thinks, just two more years.
At the closing of our sophomore year, tragedy struck. Our good friend Andy Homer was fatally wounded in a car accident. Before this misfortune, Andy left us this poem. Common thread. Everyone's linked by a common thread. First we're all living, then we're all dead. But somewhere in the middle of our birth and our grave, there's a difference in the lives that our Lord gave. Some of us are boys and some of us are girls. Some have straight hair and some have curls. I am short, you are tall. You play quiz bowl, I play ball. There's a difference in my eyes of blue and the big brown eyes that belong to you. He can't hear and she can't see. That shouldn't matter to you and me. There's a difference in shoe size and in our race. Our hair color's different and so's our taste. This is something for you to ponder, because we're all the same when we're 6 feet under. Andy, you will forever be in the hearts and minds of everyone in the class of 1997. Although you cannot be here with us today, the memory of your smiling face will last forever. We will miss you, Andy.
Following the emotional summer of 1995, our junior year began with tighter bonds and even stronger friendships. Our class got off to a slamming start with the volleyball team getting a real dig out of things all the way to state runner-up, while members of the football team tackled the year head-on and the cross-country team took off running. Homecoming came around again, and now we picked on the younger classes. Jasmine Snyder was elected as attendant and Adam Morrison was her escort. The dance was fun as everyone dressed up and danced to the music. Some of us also dressed up as we participated in our second musical, Guys and Dolls. Members of the class of 97 have lead roles belonging to Jacqueline Gunn, Nathan Harbour, and Heidi Smith. The production was a hit and there was something to sing and dance about. Speaking of singing and dancing, the choir was successful each of our underclassmen years in receiving a one at district competition advancing to state. The traveling ensemble also enjoyed performing, while others succeeded in activities such as FFA, FHA, and 4-H. School was sometimes groovy as we showed our hippie spirit, Chemistry with Mr. Weaver was always an explosive experience, and spirit for the winter sporting events interrupted the English class. Everyone found their own individual way of passing time at school. Out of school, we found time to party and hang out with our closest friends. As the weather warmed up, we moved our gatherings outdoors to take advantage of the sun. With the warmer weather came the spring sports. Jenny, Joe, and Jana enjoyed the unpredictable track weather while members of the girls' ball team tried to stay awake. For the first time, everyone was invited to the prom. Tad and Michelle enjoyed the music, while Joe seemed really pleased. These four gave new meaning to the term, Lady in Red. Became as couples, remembered their friends, and had a great time. As our junior year drew to a close, we contemplated the thought of being seniors and we liked it, which Brian Newfox, senior class president, will share with us now.
Our senior year. For many of us, it can be described as some of the best times of our lives. And for other people, well, maybe the idea. But no matter what, we will always have memories of our final high school year together. Senioritis can set in for some of us on the first day of school. But things like sports, music, and the occasional craving for knowledge kept us all from going crazy. Our football team had an outstanding season. The look on Chris's face shows us it wasn't easy. Everybody was very supportive. Even Mr. Wheeler showed up for a few games. Our cheerleaders gave the football players the most support. From hosting pep rallies to cheering at every game, the cheerleaders showed a tremendous spirit. I think it was even their idea to put a pie in Adam's face. Homecoming seemed to be here before we knew it. Summer class was crowned queen and Sean Top was king. Everybody who went to the dance had a good time. I think Jim and Jason learned a new dance move. Things like an appearance on Big Board Friday and making it to the first ever state playoff game in HL's history brought an end to the football season. And then there was the volleyball team. Our senior girls showed us that they were ready to make their third consecutive state appearance. Summer showed us her stuff on the court and encouraged the other senior girls to show their stuff in the locker room. The team may not have brought home the trophy, but we were still proud of it. Cross country and golf may not have had such a comparable season, but you can still tell that they had fun, and Jenny found her calling in life as a bus driver. Throughout our senior year, the choir members entertained us not only by singing in competitions, but also by performing before many of the basketball teams. Our senior year wasn't only a chance to continue some great friendships, it was a chance to build some new ones too. Mr. Brown even managed to get a front row seat at the game. On weekends, after everybody got their homework done, of course, we often got together just to have a good time and enjoy our senior year. Many of us spent much of the year earning money for nothing other than the class trip. Everyone who went to California in March had a good time, visiting places like the San Diego Zoo, Disneyland, and Planet Hollywood. While we were there, the time seemed to just fly by. Hey look, George is lucky enough to get his picture taken with Sean Coppers. After our trip, we performed our senior class play entitled The Rocking Horse Woman. We all knew our lines perfectly, having had so much time to practice. Prom was a lot of fun. It was our last chance to get all dressed up and spend an enormous amount of money on one night. But now it's time to head our separate ways. Many of us will go to college. Many of us